I've gotten something new for you. This paint set, or this watercolor set, which is called JerryQ. So I got this over Amazon by the price of $18.99. So I thought that we could have a look at it. This says on the back, content, one plastic box, 36 watercolor pens, two brush, one sponge, and one glass dish. So, I saw this over at Lina's channel. I will link to her in the I will be linked. So I thought that I wanted to have it as well, because I, if I can open it, I really like this tin, and it's this 36, and I have been looking for a tin that actually takes the set, and it's just not that big. So you open it up, and first you have this big, or the 30 big mixing wheels, and then you have this second one, which is then split into six parts. I don't think that you can take this off, or you might be able to take it off, but you can't attach it to the other side or some, or that you like you can with some other sets. But it lays down nice and flat, so the paint that you mix up won't float everywhere or end up on your table like other sets, and that was something that I really liked when I saw this set. Another thing is that it comes with this little sponge that is just adorable, and this ceramic dish as well. What I did not know is that it also comes with two water brushes. I think we are going to test them now. This is a flat one. This one I haven't tested out yet. And kind of a round, but it's quite thick, and it doesn't really hold a nib. So how good these are, I have no idea. I swatched out the colors. So this is the colors that you get in this set. So I find them to be quite vibrant. So they are kind of nice, and they are not as chalky as like the Parima marketing, but it is very matte. When I bet this, I found them to be very creamy, like it's like they contains plastic or something. It's something odd, and of course these are very, very cheap paints, so it has a lot of fillers, so they don't really float as good as other or more expensive paints. To really test them out, so one thing is swatching things out, but of course I had to make a picture of it, so I painted this campanile from San Marco place or square in Venice out of this reference photo made by Vitaly Dets. So it dries really nice, stays on, yeah, what can I say, kind of flat, so I do like it when it dries up. If I had to choose between these ones and the Perry, my mom, marketing, or even Jesper's Dust. I do think that I would choose these ones because Jesper's Dust, you can just wipe off with your hand. They don't stick to the paper, or not any paper that I have found. And the Parima marketing are very gritty and feels like dry sand when you touch it, but this one are not. So why I bought this is actually because I wanted the 36 set pens. So I'm going, or I'm thinking that I will remove these pens. There are no pigment info at all, no name on any colors at all. Wonder if normal half pens will fit. Let me see, I have this Cutman set here. We can try to get one of these out. Just to see if it fits. Yeah, the Vincent Newton, it fits perfectly. So I can change those out and put in my own pens as well. But I'm thinking that I will just pull them out and just fill this space here with my paint, with my tube paint, because then I get even more. So this, let me see, this round brush thingy, can I open it? So I'm thinking that I will take out all of this paints and just use the palette. And for the cost of it, if you are getting this, they are good enough, they do their work. I can't put the... That is a downer, because I would like that cap to stay on. Okay, so that was not that good. So that's I have not pre-vetted them to a day. Just want to, let me see, what did I do? I have this. Wipe that off. Let us see how they mix. Okay, might not have enough. Oh, they are quite tight when I'm squeezing water out. It's like it doesn't want to go out. That's not good. Because a water brush should give an even water flow. Oops, this mixing did not really make a nice green color. But it makes a okay, it does when I but then again with this many colors you don't really need to mix that much. But this brushes that comes with it, they are really tight. Oh my god, come on. squeezing out on the rope, that was not easy. That blue and that red as well. So let's just test this blue over here. I have no idea about the light fastness, of course. But I can't believe that they are any good at all. And I do think that these are dye based as well, because they are both cheap and the way they are acting. But I do like the tin, the tin sponge. So I have 32 grams. So I'm going to pull this one out and put them at the side and let their kids have a go at them when they want to watercolor something. And it actually lays nice and flat. I like that. So the paint is not bad, but it's not something that I would buy either for the paint. I would buy it for the palette and for this little thingy, and this sponge is just so adorable. You can fit a regular size pencil in it as well. Just pull one of this one out to probably don't need both, or you can just put a brush in it. So it actually contains it takes a lot of stuff. Closing it. No. Yeah, that works. Okay, now I can't open it. Okay. Okay. GRAC art. Grace art has made this JerryQ set. Yeah. Well, so that was it. Color has a nice, they do the job. But I would get it for the tin, because this tin is actually quite good. Amazon had it at $18.99, so I had a gift card or part of it. So I got it with that. So I guess that's it. Thank you everybody for watching, and I hope that you all have a wonderful day. Bye.